Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to draw in Affinity Designer's Pixel Persona. Okay, so I have Affinity Designer open, and I'm in the Pixel Persona here. I'm going to come up to File, New. I've got a preset 20 by 16 landscape. If you come in here, there's different options here for you to come in a color. You can start off with a transparent background. But we'll go ahead and we'll keep it with a white background for now. We could always change it to a transparent background later if we would like. So I go ahead and create this artboard. And it'll kick us right back over to the actual designer persona. So let's go ahead and click on to Pixel Persona here. Okay, so now that we've got the document set up here, I do want to cover a couple of things. However, I do have a sketching in Pixel Persona video that I'll link in the description below that covers a lot of the different basics of Pixel Persona. This video will concentrate more on the actual drawing side of it. But just a quick recap of some things here. This little rectangle with the checkerboard inside will be our pixel layer. So this will be the layer that we'll want to draw on. And then we also have our brushes up here. This is a brush category that I've created, and I've saved brushes that I use the most in here. You could purchase brush packs from Affinity or other websites as well, and you can also create your own brushes, which is something I'll be getting into in another video. So when I'm working on a drawing, an illustration, or anything in particular, I tend to use reference quite a bit. So a way that we can go ahead and bring the reference directly into our setup here, that way we don't have to look at a separate screen or our phone or anything like that, is I've already done some research and done a Google image search for some butterflies. I found one that I liked, so I've saved it, and what we'll go ahead and do now is I'll come up here to Place, File, Place. I will select the butterfly image, and I will simply click where I'd like it to be placed. I'm gonna go ahead and make that a little bit bigger. I tend to like to have it off to the right side. And something we could do too is if we want to crop this, we can hop into the designer persona real quick. We'll grab a rectangle tool. We'll draw a nice smaller square around that butterfly, and then I'll drag the butterfly image into the rectangle. So now we've kind of clipped that shape and makes it a little bit easier for us to place there. I'll hop back over to Pixel Persona. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and if you think this will work a little bit better up top here, I'm going to come over to our paintbrush tool and click on that. And up at the top bar here, you can see it says symmetry. So I'm going to go ahead and click on symmetry. And now we've got this horizontal line down here. I'm also going to go ahead and click on mirror. And as I come down here, I'm going to click and start dragging. And as I get close to vertical, I'm going to hold shift and then it'll snap into place. The assistant is popping up and telling me it's created a new pixel layer. I'll go ahead and click lock on symmetry. I don't need this pixel layer, so I'll go ahead and get rid of it. I'm going to come back down to the original pixel layer that I created earlier. I'm going to select my brush. The one I like to use for basic drawing is this Natural Pencil 4B. It comes stock in the pencil brushes in Affinity Pixel Persona. So go ahead and select that, and now we're on our pixel layer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a closer look at our butterfly picture quick and kind of see what we're dealing with here before I zoom back out and start the drawing process here. So we've got a fairly small circle for his head, a much larger oval for the main body part, and then this long thin oval for the rear of the butterfly, and then we obviously have these very nice wings that come out from there. So I do want to start in the center of my illustration, or the drawing at least, with these center shapes, and I want to try to get these proportions fairly close, and then I can move on from there and continually adjust. So in the initial drawing process, I like to stay pretty zoomed out so I can see obviously the reference image and whatnot, but staying zoomed out like this will help you not get so caught up in the details and focus more so on the whole and making sure you're getting the proportions correct. And this is just the initial drawing and sketch, so you can be very rough with it, loose. and we can always come back, which you'll see here in a minute. We'll start a new layer and we'll refine the drawing a little bit more. So I'm going to try to draw and throw your lines in one motion. So if you're going to draw a line, you want to kind of throw that line like this, as opposed to kind of jaggedy sketching it. You'll get a better result by kind of throwing the line. And we'll see this line kind of comes up into the body. Something like that. And these bottom ones are a little rounder here. So I'm liking the wings for the most part. I want to come out just a little bit more, get a little bit closer to that edge, make them a little bit larger. I do notice that I feel this back part of the butterfly could be a little bit longer. And we'll just kind of throw those little antennae in there real quick. So we're looking at basically something like this for our initial sketch here. And so I actually want to kind of change the size of this a little bit. I feel like the body of the butterfly is a little too large. So one way I can go ahead and do that is coming over here to my Move tool with this layer selected. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is hold down Control. And that'll allow me to scale around center. And now what I'll do is I'll come back to the Brush tool. My symmetry line is still in the middle. And then what I can go ahead and do here is just make these, I want to keep the same shape, but I want to just make the wings just a little bit larger. All right, so let's work on some of the details, and then we'll go ahead and refine this drawing a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and select our eraser tool over here, which is this kind of blue and red odd-shaped little pill thing over there. And I'm going to go ahead and clean some of these inside lines up a little bit. I'll go back to the paintbrush tool. And now I want to mimic kind of what I see up here in the reference as far as the inside portions of the wing. But I can be a little creative with it if I'd like. They don't have to be exactly as they are here in the reference image. So say this shape here. And then we could just keep adding. Again, I'm kind of just using the reference image as a base, and I'm kind of just going how I feel with the drawing. Because when we get into actually vectoring ink lines on this and then thinking about color, we can either stick with the color theme here, orange for the monarch butterfly, or we could switch it up and change it to a different color scheme that we might like as well. Again, we can change kind of what we're drawing here, switch it up from the reference a little bit based on what kind of shapes you like to draw and your style and whatnot. So let's zoom in here just a little bit and take a look at some of the details on his body. I'm not going to get too crazy with those details. And again, I can be a little creative with these shapes here. As I've mentioned in other videos, I'm always, as I'm drawing in this stage here, I'm always thinking about how I'm going to vector the image. How I might want to try to go about creating some of the shapes and how those shapes will come together in the actual vector process. So again, you know, we're using the reference image up here as reference. We don't have to copy it exactly. If you're a representational artist who wants to go ahead and make it look exactly the same, you know, that's cool, you do that. But for a lot of the illustration type work that I do, I like to base it in reality, but allow myself to be able to play around with some of the things to maybe make it look a little more interesting, especially for whatever the project may call for. So now to refine this a little bit more, what I'm going to go ahead and do is, this pixel layer here, I'm going to come and lower the opacity, maybe at about 50%. I'm also going to come back down here and add a new pixel layer. So I've still got my paintbrush tool selected. I've got my symmetry on. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. And these lines here are going to be my finished pencil lines prior to inking them in vector. So I'm paying a little more attention how I'm drawing the line. I'm not being as sketchy with it. I'm drawing in a very direct manner. And then this stage also will allow you, as I'm refining this drawing with the finished pencil lines, I can continue to correct some of the proportions. So I'm bringing his body in up here just a little bit, making it slightly thinner. And this is then where we can add some more of those other details. Again, stuff like this, you know, you could just have fun with. I'm going to throw a slight line in here to kind of remind myself in vector. I want to try to add some extra shadows there, perhaps. Okay, and we'll come up over here. I'm actually going to draw on this side this time. Back that up. I love the symmetry feature in the pixel persona, especially when it comes to straight-on illustrations like this or drawings like this, that you'd like to have that even symmetry on each side. It's not recommended for all art and whatnot, but again, if it fits your style, if it's what you're, the look you're going for, by all means. All right, and now for this part, I'm just going to go ahead and take our time. Now, what you can also do here, which we'll go ahead and do, we'll back that up, and I will create a new pixel layer, and I will draw the inside details of the wing on this new pixel layer. That way, I can turn this layer on and off and see whether or not I like the shapes that I've designed, or if I want to come in and try a few different designs of these shapes and see which one I might end up liking better. So always feel free to use your layers. Start a new layer, draw something on that layer. You can turn the layer on and off and see if it works for your drawing and illustration. Again, these lines have changed even from how I drew them first. I'm just playing around with these shapes, seeing how, kind of just exploring what I've got. And again, with them being on a separate layer, I can simply turn that layer off. Just going with the flow of the overall shape of the wing. And just trying a few different things there. And again, I tend to switch size when I'm drawing. It just depends on how my hand feels more comfortable in creating these shapes. Again, I'm letting these shapes kind of change and evolve a little bit as I'm working around it. And then we could come back down here at the very bottom and turn off our very first sketch layer, and this will give you a better idea of the overall look of the finished pencils here. Okay, so we have our finished pencil drawing here. In the next video, we will vector ink this butterfly, and I will provide this drawing as a download if you would prefer to work on this one, or if you have one that you drew yourself. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more drawing videos like this one. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss out on new tutorials. Until next time.